Currently in our area, 88 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. High 90. Chance of rain 60%. Tonight, thunderstorms early. Low 76. Chance of rain 40%. Monday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 95. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Good morning to you, Washington, D.C. 75 degrees. Paul, you mentioned before the way the sky looks after you get some dry air to come through and a front to clear.
I call that the Simpsons sky.
Oh, my gosh,
the
yes.
The opening credits of the Simpsons, the cartoon.
That's hilarious.
Homer and Bart.
Yes.
That's what it looks like. It's the low.
Nice.
Yeah. Don't have that haze, just very dry
this
air.
Kind of white, pancakey sort
of
cumulus.
And the flat bottom clouds.
Love
beautiful
it.
Fair
love
weather
it.
Cumulus.
But this is, this is a day after you had some flooding there, nearly 3 inches.
Don't. See what I did there?
Not see what you did there. Yeah, 2 3/4 inches inches of rainfall to be exact. Yeah,
trying to recover from that, more flooding there. In fact, a new report by the EPA says climate change, with all the impacts, including flooding, could kill more than 57,000 people every year.
We asked the president.
Switch to cleaner energy to reduce air pollution as a first course of action.
The one thing that this report and the science makes clear is that inaction is the worst choice.
And make sure you go to weather.com to see more on this issue. The Weather Channel talked to the nation's top experts for more on the price of inaction, and you can hear what they say about national security, health, and energy at weather.com/climate25. Paul?
Time now for your tropical update. A quick peek at the Atlantic. And the good news here is no activity expected. The bad news is we got no activity expected, which means the areas and the islands dealing with a drought, well, that will persist as we head through the next several days. No development expected over the next 5 days. But that's not unusual for this time of the year. We're almost in July, and we're very early in this 6-month-long season. And typically, you know, we'll see the peak of activity is late August into the early part of September, and it kind of slowly wanes as we head on towards the rest of the fall. More details coming up after this.
Hurry into Lowe's and find big summer savings for this 4th of July, like $10 off our best interior paint and primer in one, and up to $25 off all resurfacers. Plus, get 20% off all in-stock level or faux wood blinds.
This moment of independence brought to you by your U.S. Army. Every backyard comes together around a grill and Kingsford charcoal. Gather round.
Thank you. Now, can I at least he's got my shoes on?
If your bladder is calling the shots, you may have a medical condition called overactive bladder, or OAB.
You've got to be kidding me. I've had enough. It's time to talk to the doctor.
Ask your doctor how Mirbetric may help treat OAB symptoms of urgency, frequency, and leakage, which may mean fewer trips to the bathroom.
Mirbetric mirabegron may increase your blood pressure. Mirbetric may increase your chances of not being able to empty your bladder. Tell your doctor right away if you have trouble emptying your bladder or have a weak urine stream. Mirbetric may affect or be affected by other medications, so tell your doctor about all the medicines you take. Before taking Mirbetric, tell your doctor if you have liver or kidney problems. Common side effects include increased blood pressure, common cold symptoms, urinary tract infection, and headache.
Take charge by talking to your doctor about your OAB symptoms and Mirbetric. Find out if you can get your first prescription at no cost by visiting Mirbetric.com.
I'm excited to use HydroxyCut because I really want to lose weight.
Hey, we're gonna live free.
I lost 40 pounds. HydroxyCut really works.
HydroxyCut is America's number one selling weight loss supplement brand.
Lose weight your way.
Mix and match gummies, tablets, and drink mix.
Don't let more years go by and continue to pack on the pounds. Start as soon as you can.
HydroxyCut lets you lose weight your way. And look for new HydroxyCut appetite control to help curb hunger for hours.
In a matter of seconds, your life can change.
We're kids still in school.
And it just hit us.
This was it.
The Weather Channel's most watched original program is back.
Things are just going everywhere.
Was it a nightmare?
And then it was silent.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
Welcome back to Weekend Recharge on this Sunday morning. You're looking live at Olympic National Park, just northwest of Seattle. Temperatures quite comfortable in the mid-60s.
Yeah, we've got highs expected in the upper 70s. Now the location, it's location, 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 right? Between the Pacific Ocean and the Puget Sound, it's really saving this park area from the intense western heat wave.
So you can definitely go up there, hike up to the Cascades Olympics to get some snow to cool you off. They will not be dealing with the hundreds and even 90s you'll be dealing with at lower elevations. And yeah, just head up there, Mount Rainier, Mount Baker, any of those snow-capped peaks that dominate.
Well, I mean, it's just drop those names.
It's just a gorgeous part of the world. You can see these huge volcanic peaks out there. It's just, it's beautiful.
It is beautiful. This country is gorgeous. All right, so
it is amazing out there.
It got us thinking, you know, some areas are too hot today, some too cold. What about the ones that are just right? We're thinking Goldilocks and the Three Bears. For this next weather segment, it's our spin on the whole fairy tale. So let us know what you think. We're going to start off with Yakima, Washington, too hot, 111 degrees. And then you have Pittsburgh, it's 63. I'm thinking late June, 63, Pittsburgh, yeah, that's too cold.
But guess what? The ATL is just right, 83 degrees. Dew points in the 50s this morning. Temperatures dropping down to the 60s. You haven't been in the 60s in a while.
Yeah.
And enjoy it.
Pardon us if we leave a little early because we want to get out there and enjoy it.
Because so time lovely. Is ticking away.
It is, it is. But we have a couple of areas to feel in that, you know, one extreme to another. You've got Las Vegas at 109, Nashua, New Hampshire, 58 with showers, too cold.
Vegas like a sauna.
Sauna.
It was 113 yesterday. Today is a cooler day, 109. Mm-hmm. Ooh, mm-hmm. But still, Charlotte just right. Again, dew points drop there.
Yeah.
Lower humidity, 87. You got to enjoy that because, again, this is almost July.
And then you have Boise at 109, and you've got Boston at 62. East wind gusting to 30 miles per hour. Yuck.
But the Chi.
Yeah.
Chicago, 77, just right. So that's a Goldilocks and the three little cities. Forecast.
Exactly. Make the most of whatever you got, though, we always say, too. All right, Weather Geeks is just moments away. What if we said the next major natural disaster may be something you cannot see?
Well, like a solar storm, estimated cost could be as high as $3 trillion. Join Dr. Marshall Shepard next.
Currently in our area, 88 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. High, 90. Chance of rain, 60%. tonight. Thunderstorms early. Low 76. Chance of rain 40%. Monday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 95. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Hey, Weather Geeks fan, welcome to Weather Geeks. I'm Dr. Marshall Shepard, and today I'm joined by Dr. Tom Bogdan, who is the president of the UCAR and also the former director of the Space Weather Prediction Center. Tom, first of all, before we go further, we're going to be talking about space weather today, but what is UCAR? I think many of our Weather Geeks folks may not know what that is.
UCAR stands for the University Corporation for Atmospheric Research, and we're a consortium of 105 of the leading schools that carry out research in weather, climate, air quality, and yes, even space weather. Right. And we've been operating the National Center for Atmospheric Research in Boulder, Colorado, on behalf of the National Science Foundation since 1960.
Okay.
So we're a two-car family. We have the NCAR and we have the UCAR.
Yeah, and it's simply one of the top organizations in the weather enterprise.
It is.
I just wanted to make sure people understood that. But let's talk about our topic today, space weather. Are we talking about storms on Saturn or Jupiter or thunderstorms on Mars? I think space weather means something. We all know what it is, but why don't you tell us what the space weather is about?
Well, there are storms on Mars and Jupiter,
sure.
But there's storms here on Earth. And in fact, that's the sort of space weather that we pay the most attention to because we live here on this planet.
Right.
Space weather starts back at the sun, and so all of the solar system is affected by the space weather that comes from our sun.
Right.
And it takes the form, really, of three kinds of impacts.
Okay,
number
one,
bursts of electromagnetic radiation that come from solar flares.
Mm-hmm.
Typically, we're interested in the short wavelengths. Ultraviolet and X-ray is where we really pay attention. Then showers of energetic particles that can be created both at flares and coronal mass ejections. And finally, these big coronal mass ejections, which are huge kind of hurricane-like blobs of material that get ejected from the sun. And if we happen to be in the way of one of those, then we can have interesting things like aurorae and impacts.
Yeah, now talk about that, because I know people are familiar with the aurora, and we're going to talk about that a bit later in the show. But these storms and these sort of space weather phenomena that you just mentioned, they have an impact on our lives in ways that Weather Geeks viewers may not understand, but it's affecting our lives.
Absolutely, Marshall. You know, space weather's been with us for billions of years. And so often people say, why am I just hearing about
right.
it now?
Right, kind of like El Nino before 1998.
And the biggest impact of space weather was the aurora borealis, which is a very pleasant thing to look at. No drastic or horrible impacts at all.
Right.
But as our society has come to increasingly depend upon advanced technologies, things like satellite-delivered services, global positioning system, or uninterrupted access to power from complex grids that are bringing in renewables, all these advanced technologies have vulnerabilities to space weather, and as time goes by, we're becoming increasingly vulnerable, so that storms some time ago that may not have had too much of an impact today will have more of an impact.
We're going to get into a little of that in the seconds after the break as well, but just give us an example of how day-to-day life, just an example of how a major storm could really disrupt our day-to-day.
Major storms, for instance, global positioning system. We all use that
sure.
for various activities, and we have them in our cars. Space weather is the largest single source of GPS positioning error. So on a fairly quiet day, like today in Atlanta, the error caused by the ionosphere might be a couple feet, but during a big storm, it can be half a football field. Now, when you're driving your car, you're not likely to go in the ditch because it says the road is 50 yards to the right. But when you're landing a 777 in bad conditions, you need to make sure that that is not impacting
you. That's a great point, and I don't want to be on it in that case either. Now, many people that are watching the show are familiar with the National Hurricane Center or the Storm Prediction Center.
Yep.
There's actually a Space Weather Prediction Center, which you used to have. Where is that and what's going on? And do you use forecast models the way we do in weather?
Correct. So the Space Weather Prediction Center is a sister center to the National Hurricane Center down in Miami,
okay.
Also the Storm Prediction Center out in Norman. And it is run by the National Weather Service. So it's actually the National Space Weather Service as well as the Weather Service.
Okay.
Forecasts are issued there. Any of the viewers of Weather Geeks can go to spaceweather.gov,
okay.
All one word, and sign up for the types of alerts, watches, and warnings that they might be interested
okay.
in. And we also use there a sort of five-level Saffir-Simpson scale for categories of different types of storms.
Is that right?
Those that may affect satellites, GPS, or power grids.
So there is, and now, so that I just learned something new on the show, and that's what Weather Geeks is all about. But you also tell me that there are models. You were saying that models are used for predicting these storms, but they're perhaps where weather models were decades ago?
The first operational numerical space weather prediction model came on board at the National Weather Service a couple years ago.
Okay.
And what it does is it tracks the trajectories of these large coronal mass ejections.
Mm-hmm.
Now, your viewers are familiar with the cones that you get for hurricanes.
Sure.
But in three-dimensional space, what we predict are cornucopia, or kind of horns that you come out of Victrola, where that storm could go.
Ah, okay.
And that's the first operational model. The really biggest and fastest storms take 20 hours to go from sun to earth.
Mm-hmm.
And 20 hours gives us a fair amount of time to take certain levels of precautions.
And I want to ask you about that. So how do we know these storms are coming? Are we using satellite systems? What are our early warning systems?
We're using satellite
okay.
systems. There are a tremendous number of satellites out there in orbit today, both operational satellites that NOAA puts up, but also research satellites that NASA
yes,
puts in
I'm
space.
Familiar with some of those.
All of those data are made available and shared around the world in real time, so we've always got eyes on the sun, no
yes.
matter where we are.
Right, and so and that's important because the sun is so much a driver not only of our weather but our system in general. I want to get into the coronal mass ejections, but can you just define so that we have a good understanding after we come back of what that is? So
yeah.
we because that's going to be the template for our discussion after the break.
Every so often, for reasons that we still don't really understand, the sun decides to take a sizable chunk of its outer atmosphere, corona, and that's what you see during a total solar eclipse, that kind of pearly
okay.
white area, and it takes that and chucks it out into space.
Okay, and we feel that.
If we're in the path of that, we do. So during times when the sun is not very active, it may do that once every week.
Okay, well, we'll pick up on that after the break. But when we come back, these solar storms like that, they could be a $1 trillion impact on the economy. I said trillion with TR. We'll talk about that next. But first, our Geek of the Week.
Kelly Beatty, senior editor at Sky and Telescope, is this week's Geek of the Week. Yes, Kelly loves dense fog because it reminds him of his early years in California. But I'll tell you what, that fog better not get in the way of viewing the wonders of the universe. Mm-mm, not through a telescope, no way, because Kelly has a passion for astronomy. In fact, he even has the Twitter handle. Yes, check this out. Night Sky Guy. Oh, it doesn't get better than that, does it? So here's to clear skies and Kelly Beatty, our Geek of the Week.
Rise. It's a fast way to borrow. With cash in your account, as soon as tomorrow. Helping you get back to what matters most. Visit risecredit.com today.
Amore.
Subito.
No!
The all-new Fiat 500X crossover. With 70 standard and available safety features, including options like all-wheel drive and blind spot monitoring, it's eye candy that watches the road.
No!
One day, a rider made a decision.
I'm ready.
The decision to ride on and save money. He decided to save money by switching his motorcycle insurance to Geico. There's no shame in saving money. Ride on, ride proud. Geico Motorcycle, Great rates for great rides.
A new episode of Fat Guys in the Woods, tonight at 9 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 88 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. High 90. Chance of rain 60%. Tonight, thunderstorms early. Low 76. Chance of rain 40%. Monday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 95. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Channel's most watched original program,
and it just hit us,
is back.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
In a world of fake, fried, and frozen, Boston Market promises to make food good. Like our all-natural rotisserie chicken. Now meals start at just $6.99. Boston Market, all good.
Six smoky hours, one tasty dish, slow-braised pulled pork, now at Boston Market.
The Sea-Doo Spark. It's bringing the fun your family has been dreaming of. Easy to own and a thrill to ride. But the biggest rush is realizing you can own one now. The Sea-Doo Spark, starting at $49.99.
Please rise for our national anthem.
This moment of independence brought to you by your U.S. Army.
Did you know only 1% of supplements have earned the USP mark? An independent certification for quality and purity. I recommend Nature Made because they've earned the most of any brand.
Nature Made, the number one pharmacist recommended letter vitamin brand.
Bridgestone's new Ecopia Plus tires are fuel efficient and engineered to give you 20 extra miles per tank.
20 extra miles? Good, because usually I have to stop and fill up there.
Hit me, Ben.
Wait, why is there a green?
And we are back on Weather Geeks talking about space weather. You probably have a cell phone or a smartphone in your palm right now or sometime today. That could be affected by these events. Now, we were talking before the break about coronal mass ejections and how they can affect our life on this planet. Mm-hmm. What are some of the more destructive ones in recent memory that come to mind for you?
The biggest storm we've ever seen of that sort came in 1859, and it's called the Carrington Event. And the only reason we knew how big a geomagnetic storm it was in 1859 was we had our first advanced technology, telegraph wires.
Yeah.
And telegraph wires, just like our power grid, is like a big antenna
right. That
is sitting out there. When the coronal mass ejection comes in, it pushes on the Earth's magnetic field.
Oh, wow. Okay.
You know, we're very lucky here. We have a blank of an atmosphere that protects us from the charged particles and the radiation. We have a big magnetosphere around the planet that protects us from
right. That.
But on the front side of the Earth, the magnetic field is pointing up from south to north. And so if that incoming mass ejection has a southward pointing magnetic field, its entry into the system. And so 1859 was a huge storm that had the right orientation of its magnetic field. And what started to happen was amazing. The telegraph operators realized they could disconnect the batteries and continue to operate their telegraphs.
Oh, wow.
Because natural power was being supplied by the storm.
That makes sense from a physics standpoint. Now tell me, so in some ways that was almost like the perfect space weather storm, but tell me a little bit about, we talked about the real impact. You were telling me earlier that it's not a matter of if, but when we're going to have a devastating storm that could just really disrupt life, $3 trillion. I mean, I know that estimate's out there, but I mean, what does that look like if that storm happening today?
If an 1859 caliber storm happened today, and we of course know it did happen, we witnessed it, The big impact would be on our power grid. So instead of the telegraph wires, it's the power transfer wires that current goes, and the big impact is on transformers that sit at the end of those. Transformers do not like current ending up in them. We can burn them out, we can render them inoperable, and it turns out that we don't keep spare transformers. We don't keep a spare home.
Right.
We don't keep a spare transformer. Yeah. And so the big trillion-dollar impacts that people have talked about is a big event that took out a large number of transformers up and down the East Coast and the Upper West. Texas and the middle area would probably likely be saved from those impacts because of where they are.
Yeah.
And without power for potentially weeks, months, perhaps even a year, you can see the entire economy collapses. We can't exist without power.
I just don't think people really have a grasp of that. So I hope this is really enlightening to our viewers. I mean, the power grid, aviation, even precision seed and farming you were talking about. Now, another interesting aspect of this, and we've got probably about a minute or so, you were talking about how the amount of space junk, the sort of debris and leftover satellites are actually affected by space weather. Tell us a little bit about that, because I found that fascinating.
When we get solar flares and a lot of solar flaring activity, it heats up our atmosphere and it kind of puffs out in response to that. That puffing causes drag on debris that's left there, garbage, and it causes it to deorbit and burn up nicely and cleans out that space.
Wow.
Our sun has been kind of quiet, relatively speaking.
What do you mean by a quiet sun?
The sun has seasons just like we have here on Earth. Our seasons are a year, and it's because of the tilt of the Earth's axis. The sun's season is about 12 years, and it is active during solar max, quiet during solar max.
I wanted to make sure we got that out. We'll come back more, but when we come back after the break, we're going to talk about the more beautiful side of space weather, the northern lights, the aurora. Dr. Bogdan will give us more on that next on Weather Geeks.
Robots might build cars, but it takes human hands to keep them running right. Right now at Firestone Complete Auto Care, get a synthetic blend oil change for only $19.99. Firestone Complete Auto Care. Whatever you drive, drive on Firestone.
Firestone Complete Auto Care. Maintenance, repairs, tires. Whatever you drive, drive a Firestone.
A little prep goes a long way with Scotch-Blue Painter's Tape. The one with 3M adhesive technology for less paint bleed-through and amazing results so you can forget about the redo. Pull off a better paint job with Scotch-Blue Painter's Tape.
Next.
Expected wait time, 55 minutes. Your call is important to us. Thank you for your patience.
In the nation, we know how it feels when you aren't treated like a priority. We do things differently.
We'll take care of it.
We put members first.
Thank you.
Join the nation.
Nationwide is on your side.
The thing is, people think boys are loud and immature and don't care about feelings, but they're wrong.
Thanks.
Kleenex. Someone needs one.
Can a protein originally found in a jellyfish improve your memory? Our scientists say yes. Researchers have discovered a protein that actually supports healthier brain function. It's the breakthrough in a supplement called Prevagen. As we age, we lose proteins that support our brain. Prevagen supplements these proteins and has been clinically shown to improve memory. It's safe and effective. For support of healthier brain function, a sharper mind, and clearer thinking, try Prevagen for yourself today.
Glad you're with us right here on AMHQ, the whole team.
Right, either go all in or just tap out.
Here we go. I told you, we're going to bust out of this drought.
As we say, keep watching with us this morning because we're all watching history happen together.
Things move fast around here. Who's got time to look at the fine print? So you see DirecTV's new offer. $19, you think. But after just 3 months, you're paying over $100 a month, and it keeps going up. Turns out you're locked into a two-year contract that could cost you nearly $3,000. Thinking about DirecTV? Think again.
Don't fall for DirecTV's latest offer. There's nothing direct about DirecTV.
At Alpacher Lincoln, we want you to have luxury for less this summer.
That's why we offer the best savings and selection. Savings, like a 2015 Lincoln MKX, just $389 a month. Or a 2015 Lincoln Navigator, just $599 a month. Savings, with bottom line windshield pricing. Selection, over 200 new Lincolns to choose from. Only at Alpacker Lincoln on Military Trail. And remember,
before you ride, Price Packer.
A new episode of Fat Guys in the Woods, tonight at 9 on the Weather Channel.
In a matter of seconds, your life can change.
We're kids still in school.
And it just hit us.
This was it.
The Weather Channel's most watched original program is back.
Things were just going everywhere. It was a nightmare.
And then it was silent.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
Currently in our area, 87 degrees, under mostly cloudy skies. Today, scattered showers or thunderstorms. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Rainfall near an inch. Tonight, thunderstorms early. Low 76. Chance of rain 40%. Monday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 95. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Hey, and we're back on Weather Geeks. Now, before we geek out on the Aurora, I wanted to ask you about the Discover satellite, because it's an important tool that was recently launched. Tell us quickly about that.
Absolutely. As I mentioned earlier, these big hurricanes or coronal mass ejections, the very fastest ones will take 20 hours to get from sun to earth. And we watch them lift off from the sun, and our models compute their trajectory. But it's always nice to have proof positive.
Yeah, validation, sure.
And so there's a funny place called the L1 Lagrange point. The geeks will love that.
No, we love that. That's
it's about 1% of the distance between sun and earth. And it's a stable place where you can place a satellite that always remains between sun and earth.
Right.
And that's where Discover just ended up this very week.
Right.
If it takes 20 hours, that storm passes over this point, and you've got about 20 to 40 minutes before planet fall. And here we make measurements of all the properties of that hurricane CME. The orientation of that field, is it south or is it north? And that's what Discover does. It's our sentinel. It's like having someone off the coast giving you hurricane measurements before.
Yeah, and that just further illustrates the value of space observations for not only looking outward, but looking close to the sun and back home to Earth as well. Now, speaking of space, I saw some recent photos from one of the astronauts on the space station, and it was really neat. It was showing the night lights of the U.S., and it had the Aurora Borealis off in the distance. Tell us what those are. I know many of our Weather Geeks viewers are fascinated by it, but what causes those?
So the aurora is really the manifestation of space weather we're all most familiar with. When that coronal mass ejection comes in and pushes on that magnetic field, on the backside, the magnetic field lines will often reconnect, and that creates energy. That creates particles that flow back down the field lines into the polar regions. As they pass through the atmosphere, they excite atoms of nitrogen, sure, oxygen, and all those marvelous colors are transitions.
Right.
So these are energetic electrons precipitating.
So yeah, it's really just a nice interplay of physics, space weather, and meteorology in some regards, I would imagine.
It is.
Now, tell me a little bit about the sun cycles and how they impact weather here on Earth. But you talked earlier about the sun cycles and seasons.
So the sun season, as we said, is about 12 years or so. Sometimes it's 11, sometimes it's 14. We've been watching this cyclic behavior all the way back to 1600.
Mm-hmm.
We've seen those cycles. We still don't know precisely why. We know three things are critical for it. First of all, the sun rotates. Mm-hmm. Rotation is important. Secondly, it convects. You see a lot of convection out on the high plains.
Absolutely.
The outer 30% of the sun is always convecting like crazy.
Right.
And finally, there's a magnetic field. We know when you put those three things together, you create energy in magnetic fields that can then be liberated episodically in flares or coronal mass ejections.
Okay, so that makes sense, yeah.
The impact on actual weather has been an exciting topic that a lot of people have looked at for over the last 100 years. We know that the actual amount of energy the sun puts out varies with the solar cycle as well.
Right, so we always talk about a solar constant, but it's actually not technically constant.
It's not constant. Yeah. On short time scales, it can change by a percent as dark sunspots come on the limb.
Right.
But when you average over a solar cycle, it's about 1 part in 10 to the 3, or 1/10 of a percent. And that really is not enough to cause huge changes in our climate, not like what we've seen lately.
Right. So it's, you know, when those people say it's just the sun, it's certainly a contributor, but not the primary focus. Now we've got about 30 seconds left. What's next? What's the next big thing in space weather that, from your lens?
The next thing is going to be really predicting flares.
Okay.
We can see the coronal mass ejections leave the sun, and we watch them 20 hours, maybe more. But nothing travels faster than the speed of light.
Right.
When a flare takes, we can't find it out any sooner than the 8 minutes from sun to Earth.
Right.
So that's the holy grail.
So just like in weather on Earth, sort of resolving those shorter-term timescales in some regard.
Understanding when tornadoes form, when do flares form, what are the conditions?
Right. That's where we have to end it. Thank you for joining us, Tom. We thank you for joining us. As always, we're on Twitter at WXGeeksTWC. And you can also like us on Facebook and see some of our former episodes. Join us next week again on Weather Geeks. See you next week.
Pass down a Subaru Forester.
She's all yours.
But you get to keep the memories.
Love. It's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
At WeatherTech, we never stop inventing ways to keep your vehicle protected. From floor liners and cargo liners to dozens of other world-class quality products, including no-drill mud flaps and bump step. Nothing is better for your car, truck, or SUV than WeatherTech for your family. The whole family. Go to WeatherTech.com to find the ultimate vehicle protection, along with a full line of automotive accessories. Nothing protects like WeatherTech.
At last.
Sometimes at last doesn't happen at first.
My love has come along. My lonely days.
Your dad just kissed my mom.
Turning two worlds into one takes love.
And life is like a song.
Helping protect that world takes State Farm.
One can of Bush's beans.
Well, this is a predicament. Home style sounds good, but country style, not without its charms. New brown sugar hickory? Who says no to new? Single serve vegetarian? Sure. There are no rules here. No rules on aisle 4.
With 17 delicious flavors cooked according to our secret family recipe, Bush's has the variety you can't resist.
Did you get a can of Bush's beans?
Yes. Yes, I did.
Bush's beans. What's your favorite flavor?
When the day arrives a little earlier and lingers a little later, you can be sure it's summer. And for this bounty, so little is expected in return. Only that we find ways, big and small, to milk every last second of it. To use a little imagination and make a whole lot of memories. Low prices every day on everything you need to get away from it all. Walmart.
It may seem strange, but people really can love their laxative, especially when it's Miralax. It hydrates, eases, and softens to unblock your system naturally, so you have peace of mind from start to finish. Love your laxative, Miralax.
Want the best vision under the sun?
Experio UV. Superior polarized sun lenses eliminate 100% of blinding reflective glare and offer maximum UV protection. Ask for Experio UV in your prescription for the best vision under the sun.
In the long term, climate change is a strategic threat. Example that I use all the time is what's happened in Mali. Agriculture was their main source of both revenue and food. Severe drought there over the last several years. They had to move. They went north. Well, they weren't welcome in the north. And as a consequence, there was a war in essence. We know climate change caused this.
The Weather Channel presents 25 Unexpected Voices. Hear their stories at climate25.com.
Currently in our area, 87 degrees, under mostly cloudy skies. Today, scattered showers or thunderstorms. High 91. Chance of rain 60%. Rainfall near an inch. Tonight, thunderstorms early. Low 76. Chance of rain 40%. Monday, thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. High 95. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
In a matter of seconds, your life can change.
We're kids still into school.
And it just hit us.
This was it.
The Weather Channel's most watched original program is back.
Things were just going everywhere. Was it a nightmare?
And then it was silent.
This is just the beginning of what's to come.
Tonight, on an all-new episode of Fat Guys in the Woods.
For these three radio DJs, this is a nightmare.
What are we gonna do for food?
I mean, that's what we're doing, man. It's real simple. Kill it and eat it.
A new episode of Fat Guys in the Woods, tonight at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
We have uncovered a remarkable planet. A world of extreme weather. Alien landscapes. And bizarre phenomena. It's the most complex system we know of in the universe. That planet is Earth. And we are only beginning to unlock its secrets. They are the heartbeat of the ocean. But they have a secret.
It'd be like being hit by a car traveling at 25 miles per hour.
Some can rage out of control.
You've got water flowing into the subways. You've got water at the World Trade Center.
They're called tides. Generated by the celestial pull of a moon and sun. Aggravated by weather and land. And wielding the power to trigger some of the deadliest disasters on the planet. On Secrets of the Earth. Even from space, it's clear that one feature separates Earth from all the rest of the planets in this solar system. Over 70% of its surface is covered with water. Where the sea meets the land, the waters rise and fall in predictable patterns known as tides. But closer inspection reveals that sometimes these tides get out of control.
When a tide is coming in slowly at the seashore, it may seem kind of meek,
But tides actually have tremendous power.
What makes the gentle heartbeat of the oceans rage in certain places on the planet? Here, in a 50-mile-long inlet off the eastern coast of Canada, tides are taken to their most extreme. This is the Bay of Fundy, home of the highest tides on the planet. A typical high tide is about 2 to 4 feet. But throughout the year, the tides in the Bay of Fundy can rise to over 50 feet, the height of a 5-story building.
115 billion tons of water comes into the Bay of Fundy, and 150 billion tons of water goes out of the Bay of Fundy. To put that in context, the force of the water moving in and out of the Bay of Fundy is equivalent to about 8,000 locomotives pulling that water in and out of the bay.
The sheer load of water moving in and out of the Bay of Fundy actually tilts the province of Nova Scotia back and forth by 1/16th of an inch during each tide cycle. If the energy of these tides could be harnessed, they could generate upwards of 10,000 megawatts of electricity, enough to power over 3 million homes a day. These powerhouse tides not only achieve awesome vertical heights, they also span almost 200 miles of coastline. So when the water retreats, it exposes hundreds of thousands of acres of the ocean floor.
We're at low tide at Alma Harbor. And if this were high tide, I'd be 6 feet underwater. And as the tide continues to go down, I'd be able to walk out for 1 to 2 miles.
But what is the secret that drives these mysterious waters in the Bay of Fundy? All tides on Earth, no matter how extreme, are powered by a force from space.
Tides are mostly caused by the gravitational influence of the moon, and to a lesser extent, that of the sun. The moon pulls on the near side of the Earth more than it pulls on the center, causing the near side to bulge out toward the moon a little bit. It also pulls on the center more than on the far side, causing the far side to bulge out from the center. So there are two bulges on either side. It consists of water that's bulging toward the moon and away from the moon, and to a lesser extent, toward the sun and away from the sun.
As the moon revolves around the Earth and the planet orbits the sun, these tidal bulges cause the water to rise and fall, producing high tides and low tides. The tides in the Bay of Fundy begin with the gravitational pull of the moon, but they are taken to the extreme by the bay's unique funnel shape. As it juts in from the sea, the inlet quickly narrows and becomes extremely shallow. When the tide rushes in, the water piles up. But there's another secret that propels these tides to astonishing heights. In addition to the small waves you see crashing on the shore, there is a larger, overall rocking motion in any body of water. In the Bay of Fundy, the time it takes for this large rocking motion to go from the mouth of the bay to shore and back again is around 12 hours. Since ocean tides happen to rise and fall around every 12 hours too, at the precise time the water has rocked back toward the mouth of the bay, another high tide arrives to push it back in. This reinforces the rocking, amplifying the tide upwards to 50 feet.
Not 2 hours ago, the boats were about 15 feet higher at the high tide mark, the high water mark, which is that change in color you can see over there between dark and light. The boats are now sitting on the sea floor.
For hundreds of millions of years, the tides in the Bay of Fundy have chiseled away at sandstone rock to form dramatic coastal structures like these towering sea stacks that look like gigantic flower pots.
With time, as coastal erosion continues, these sea stacks will essentially collapse and new ones will form.
The tides in the Bay of Fundy not only erode the shoreline, they also have the power to kill. People occasionally find themselves strolling a mile from shore when the tide turns. January 20th, 2012. Two fishermen drowned when searching for lobster traps during low tide in the Bay of Fundy.
Tides in the Bay of Fundy come in at the rate of an inch every minute, so they're incredibly fast. You could potentially be swept away from these strong tidal currents.
The Bay of Fundy may have the highest ocean tides on Earth, but halfway across the planet, a different type of treacherous tide rules the bay.
Bridgestone's revolutionary drive car tires are engineered to take a puncture and drive up to 50 miles on a flat.
I feel unstoppable, like a superhero.
With a sidekick.
Yeah. You're my sidekick, right, bud?
No.
Okay.
If you're an adult with type 2 diabetes and your A1C is not at goal with certain diabetes pills or daily insulin, your doctor may be talking about adding medication to help lower your A1C. Ask your doctor if adding once-a-week Tanzium is right for you. Once-a-week Tanzium is an injectable prescription medicine that may improve blood sugar in adults with type 2 diabetes, along with diet and exercise. Once-a-week Tanzium works by helping your body release its own natural insulin when it's needed. Tanzium is not recommended as the first medicine to treat diabetes or in people with severe stomach or intestinal problems. Tanzium is not insulin. It is not used to treat type 1 diabetes or diabetic ketoacidosis and has not been studied with mealtime insulin. Do not take Tanzium if you or your family have a history of medullary thyroid cancer or multiple endocrine neoplasia syndrome type 2, or if you're allergic to Tanzium or any of its ingredients. Stop using Tanzium and call your doctor right away if you experience symptoms of a serious allergic reaction, which may include itching, rash, or difficulty breathing. If you have signs of pancreatitis, such as severe stomach pain that will not go away and may move to your back, with or without vomiting. Or if you have symptoms of thyroid cancer, which include a lump or swelling in your neck, hoarseness, trouble swallowing, or shortness of breath. Before using Tanzium, talk to your doctor about your medical conditions, all medicines you're taking, if you're nursing, pregnant, or may become pregnant, and about low blood sugar and how to manage it. Taking Tanzium with a sulfonylurea or insulin increases your risk for low blood sugar. Common side effects with Tanzium include diarrhea, nausea, injection site reactions, cough, back pain, and cold or flu symptoms. Some serious side effects can lead to dehydration, which may cause kidney failure. Ask your doctor if adding once a week Tanzium is right for you. Go to Tanzium.com to learn if you may be eligible to receive Tanzium free for 12 months. Make every week a Tanzium week.
Episode of Fat Guys in the Woods, tonight at 9 on the Weather Channel.
There is a place on Earth where an extreme tide can sometimes be downright vicious. The east coast of China. Here, just south of Shanghai, the waters of the South China Sea surge through the bottleneck-shaped Hangzhou Bay. As water piles up at the narrow mouth of the Qiantang River, the incoming tide forms a long wave of water that barrels up the river against its current, rising to 30 feet tall and moving at 25 miles per hour. It's known as a bore tide. Unlike a normal tide, this tidal phenomenon occurs when a forceful incoming tide creates a wave of water that pushes up a narrowing river or bay against the current.
The standing wave forms because the water that's building up can't dissipate fast enough because the tide's rising so quickly.